Hi, this is Curt Bonk coming to you from lovely Bloomington, Indiana, the home of the Indiana Hoosiers. I'm in Studio 101. Wait a minute. There is no Studio 101. I just made that up. But I'm not making this up. You're in a free class. A free class on instructional ideas and technology tools for online learning success. Now here in Indiana, we have very sophisticated building in this studio. Studio 101, smiley man? Well, it's not Studio 101, he tells me, but it's a nice place. We have the top program in instructional systems technology, and we have really great support for technology in education. So I'm going to be talking to you about some things we do here, but really what I see happening around the world. That's the focus here. It's the global nature of this free class, this what they're calling a MOOC, a massive open online class. Say it with me, MOOC. One, two, three, everyone, MOOC. Now some of you, I know, you like the technology side of the MOOC. Okay? How many of you are Facebook fans? You're in Facebook all the time or checking email or text messaging on your smartphones and my dumb phone here. I go to Korea with my dumb phone and they look at my LG phone and say, whoever sold you that? I said, you sold me that. They only have smartphones in Korea. Anyhow, we're going to have a MOOC, and we're going to combine those instructional ideas, pedagogy, nurture, with technology, nature, and it's an interactional model. We'll fit them together and then talk about success of both the instructors teaching online and the students. So instructional ideas and technology tools for online success, online learner success, online teacher success. And, you know, I'm flabbergasted. There are thousands of people already signing up for this in a couple of days. So I thought I'd do this little video intro just to say hi to all of you before we meet, because it's hard for me getting into all your introductions and giving you feedback, but I'm trying and I'm reading, and there's some fascinating discussions from Barbados and coming from Cincinnati and coming from India or coming from the UK. You know, I'm reading things from Houston last night and here in Indiana there's people posting. You know, so you're in Blackboard Course Sites. Blackboard Course Sites people have brought us this free class. They're supporting it with blogs, with discussion forums, with the synchronous sessions, with announcements, with papers posted you can read each week. So you'll be reading some things that I've written and other people have written. Then we'll have the synchronous sessions on Wednesdays. What time was that, smiley man? Wednesdays, he said. But that's... Oh, he cautions me that that's only here in the U.S. and part of Europe. You see, 4 p.m. Eastern time, 1 p.m. Pacific time, 3 p.m. Houston and Chicago time, St. Louis time, Milwaukee, where I grew up. But it's different over in, you know, Abu Dhabi and Dubai, my friends in Dubai. Dubai Men's College, Dubai Women's, High Mark. It's midnight there. They got to stay up a little bit late, even later, going on, pushing on into Pakistan or into India or going to Asia. We're, you know, getting in near 4 in the morning, 5 in the morning. My friends in Seoul and over in Singapore and in Sydney and in New Zealand and Waikato or Auckland. You know, as we see things happening in Beijing at 5 a.m., you'll be asking me questions. Some of you will have bones to pick. But you know, you all are going to be fishing for an answer, and I'll have fish, other people will have fish for you, they'll give you the answers that you're looking for, maybe. But the important thing is that we discuss, we collaborate, we share. So week one, we'll start with motivation online, and a model, a framework, I call tech variety, and every letter of tech variety stands for a motivational principle. So tone, engagement, curiosity, variety, and so on. I'll be giving you some low risk, low cost, low time activities. Because you see, not everybody has the $1 million stimulus package and these millions that Blackboard gave me for doing, maybe Blackboard didn't give me $1 million. But okay, I can send you a few of these, but not everybody has millions. So we're making this free and we're going to talk about low risk, low cost, low time. And for people that have some money, some high risk, high cost, high time things, some extreme learning kinds of things that I'm researching, right? So we'll do this first week on motivation and retention. Week two, we'll get into diversity. We'll get into learning preferences, learning needs. Some people call it learning styles. And instead of 10 principles, we'll get into 4. We'll divide up the web into reading, reflecting, displaying, and doing with my R2-D2 model. You see, because there's so much that you can do online today, people, you know, just get so excited about the possibilities in cyber schools or teaching a language online, or they might get Tom Reed's and Jan Harrington's book, Ron Oliver's Authentic E-Learning. Sorry, Tom, I'm throwing your book up in the air. Or, you know, you might be in China or in one of the Arab countries reading about the world becoming more open, right? But there's so much out there today that we have to make sense of it with some frameworks. So the R2D2 framework, tech variety frameworks, are ways to make sense of it all. And that will be week two. We'll have every week at 4, remember 4 o'clock, 1 o'clock Pacific, midnight in Abu Dhabi, 4 a.m. for my friends in Asia, 5 a.m., 6 a.m. We'll have an hour of presentation, then an hour of Q&A. We'll have a break somewhere in between after the first hour or so, or 55 minutes, and then we'll come back 5 or 10 minutes later. So if you want to leave, you can go, but we're adding a second free Q&A hour every week. Now, what do you get at the end? No, I'm not going to give you $1 million. I may give you a book. We'll have a raffle, but you'll get a badge out there. A few of you might get Top Banana Awards. Some of you may get light bulbs going off in your head of new things, new ideas that you can use in your classes, right? So that gets us through 2 weeks. The third week, hyper-engaging strategies for creativity, critical thinking, collaboration. Because, you know, we read these books on cracking creativity. We might read a book on collaborative learning. And we might read things on, you know, collaborative learning online or learner-centered classrooms and so forth, you know. But people need frameworks, they need guidelines, they need some, you know, step by step, and we'll not only have that, we'll discuss it with each other. And it's really not me, it's not Blackboard people, it doesn't matter. It's not what's happening in Indiana, doesn't matter. What really matters in all of this, what's really important in all of this, is the fact that we're going to be discussing, collaborating, sharing what's going on online. So that's week 3. Week 4 is set up for Q&A. 2 hours of Q&A. Just bring me your questions and ask me them, okay? Maybe, maybe not, okay? You might be frustrated. My bendy guy here. But I've been talking about video for the past 6 months to a year, and I created actually about a year and a half ago, 27 shared online videos, free to the world. My dean said to me, his name is Jack Cummings, and Jack said, Curt, let's make these videos free to the world. So we did 27 videos with help from my friend Peter Von Lusen, the Instructional Consulting Office, Karen Hallett, Miguel Laura, Jake Ainfield, and now Ilho Zhang, all of them helping me put these videos up on the web, 27 on plagiarism, assessment, managing a class, giving feedback on a class, creating communities, global collaboration, and then technology things on podcasts, wikis, blogs. Go to the V portal. VP, the video primers in an online repository of e-teaching and learning, YMCA or whatever, okay? Well, just check out the V portal. If you can't find it, type in V portal in Google or go to my homepage. Underneath my picture is a link to the V portal. These are all free. You can share them, download them, look at them, remix them. Take only a bit of it and reuse it and use it in your program. Maybe even sell it if you thank us. So those videos we'll watch in week 4. Now I might present a bit about video in week 4 if people twist my arm or talk to me about it. If you don't want me, if you get bored of hearing from me, we'll just watch the videos and chat. Week 5, Blackboard people will take over. I'll still be there. And they'll be talking about all the tools we used, all the things we did, all the places you can go, all the things maybe we didn't use. Beyond the blogging tool, the discussion forums, these synchronous, you know, Blackboard collaborate tool and announcement tools and so forth. So this is the first MOOC that Blackboard's doing, a massive open online class. Again, say it with me, MOOC. 1, 2, 3, MOOC, okay? 1, 2, 3, MOOC. So I hope we all can be fellow MOOCers and, you know, we'll get our shirts. Maybe that's what Blackboard can give us all, MOOC shirts or something like that, I don't know. And you'll get a badge at the end if you complete this. And some of you will raffle off some books and so forth, but that's not important. You know, it's not the tangible things. It's about meeting people. It's about life. It's about empowerment moments in the life process. It's about change with technology. You see, I'm a product of distance learning. I was a board accountant and CPA taking courses through the TV and correspondence in the early to mid-1980s. that got me into grad school. And so what I'm exciting here is for a couple of reasons. One, millions of people today are being impacted by online learning. I had a chance to be impacted by TV and correspondence. Think about all the people that could have been impacted decades ago by online web-based environments. Number two, not many people have been trained to teach this way. This class will enable you to have some strategies. I'm not expecting you to use all of them, and we'll talk about K-12 stuff. We'll talk about higher ed stuff. We'll talk about even some military examples and some government ones. Most will be higher ed, but I'm interested in learning environments for everybody. The whole world is open for learning today. The world is open. And you know, for me, that one thing, that opportunity to learn and access was a life changer. Think about the people you can impact with one simple idea, one strategy. That's the goal here. So not use all this, but to use maybe some of these frameworks or create your own frameworks. I don't care if you use any of this, but to start the discussion, to start people talking and sharing. So this is a global time. I'm really interested in meeting those of you in other countries. Not just people from the US. I have a few friends here, but I want to meet some people coming from England, who are coming from India, who are coming from Pakistan, who are coming from Kenya and Colombia and Argentina and back in my friends in Korea and Mongolia and Russia and you name it around the world, Mexico, Canada. I hope that you know all of you can form a community about teaching and learning online. Maybe we can do a product together about best practices. Who knows where we can go with it, but I'm looking forward to next week. May 2nd here in the States, May 3rd over in Asia. Come meet us, sign up for this free MOOC, Massive Open Online Class, Instructional Ideas and Technology Tools for Online Learning Success. 4 p.m., 1 hour presentations. This is Curt Bonk from Studio 101. Isn't that right, Smiley Man? Studio 101. We're going to christen the Studio 101, Smiley Man tells me. And so hopefully you'll all be smiling next week at this time from learning something from the class. If not, I'll send you a smiley ball. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.